Hi, it's T with TeaQuilts, and we're back to sew our block B's for the Harley Treads t-shirt quilt. And if you are substituting other blocks, this will still apply to you as well. For this segment, we need to have B blocks. We need them to be 18 by 18 finished. So that means that they'll be 18 and 1/2 by 18 and 1/2 unfinished. And we need to make 7 of those. So I have pulled out some of my t-shirts that I want to use in these positions, and so I have all 7 of my patterns here, and I am going to make these into 18.5 inch unfinished squares. Now, for some of these, if you've got enough room, you can just go ahead and cut an 18.5 inch square, but I am going to be adding some strips onto them. I may not do a frame all the way around. I may just add a strip to one side, and that just might be it for that particular block. It just depends on where it's going to sit in the quilt top. So let me bring this back. I have my grid here, and I will also put it up on the screen so you can take a screenshot of this video and you can use this as your planning. I have already made my block A. I needed 2 of those, so I have 2 block A's, and notice that some of my B blocks will be touching this A block. So my A block here has an orange border around it. I'm also have an orange fabric here, so maybe I might want to put some strip along here so that I'm not putting this orange fabric up next to the orange border that's on my A block. So I'm going to be paying attention to that as I'm making these blocks, as well as where these blocks touch. So these 5 blocks, you may want to make sure you plan your coloring appropriately. And then these 2 blocks, you can just make any way you like, because when we add these blocks in, you can fix the patterns and fabrics that you're using so that you don't have something that's just gross next to each other sitting in your quilt top. So that's what I'm going to do. I will probably just come back and show you what I've cut. I'm going to cut my blocks down. If you need to know how to make your blocks fit, go back and look at the block A video that I have uploaded previous to this, and you will understand how to make your blocks. But I'm not going to do that every month, but I will come and show you my finished blocks as I am making them. So I will be back in a bit when I decide what I'm going to cut. So I'm back with my first B block that I have made, and I just wanted you to know that you don't have to use the same fabric all the way around. Each one of my strips are a different size, and I didn't even put a strip on the bottom. But as long as this totals up to 18.5 inches, then we're ready to go. So I just wanted to come back and show you what I did with the first one. And now I'm just going to go ahead and trim up my other ones. And some of them probably will have some form of a sashing, but I'm hoping that I can even just cut some of them into an 18.5 inch square. So I will see you when I come back. It's actually the next day, and I am back with my completed blocks. I have 7 of my B blocks. And I did label them with the actual number, so just to know that I did all 7 of them. So they all have different sashings around them to make them all equal 18.5 inch unfinished. So they're 18.5 inch from edge to edge. This one I just put some scraps I had left over and filled out this area. Here I just needed one piece on the side. Another one where I just needed one piece on the side. This one I decided to go all the way around and even add some cornerstones. And this one I went all the way around with the frame, but no cornerstones. And this one, I just needed two pieces and I didn't need them to be the exact same size. So just showing you some different things that you can do. If you are piecing this for yourself or someone that loves additional patchwork, again, you can put additional patchwork in here. But since this is a customer's quilt and they're not paying for a whole lot of fancy patchwork, so I am not doing that in this particular quilt. So that's it for this video. If you have pictures you'd like to send, please email them to teaquilts@teaquilts.com. Please share this video with your friends, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.